Let's welcome
So,
Dr. Sarika with us.
yeah, can you see my screen?
Yes, ma'am.
So I'm
Yes, ma'am.
actually thrilled to see so many girls here to talk about their health and to know about their body. So we'll be talking about something which is not openly spoken. So I want all of you to be very frank with me and ask as many questions as you have about your periods or menses, and we'll talk everything about it. Even the silliest question which you think are small ones, which you think you don't understand, everything you can ask. But I think after once I finish the session, keep your questions ready, type them in the chat box, or you can later ask questions. So let's talk about it. So so we all know about puberty. I hope that there is a chapter on puberty in your science book. And if I tell you in just one line, it is the physical and the mental changes which happen between the age of 10 to 14 years. So it is something, it is the time where you are changing or transforming into adult. So it is physical changes or mental changes. So what are the physical changes? The physical changes I am sure you all are having right now is that the breasts start developing. You will have a little heavier breast each year. There will be hairs in the armpit and the private areas. So these hairs are earlier very thin, but later on they become thick and dark colored. So this is one change. I'm sure that you are seeing these things in your body. The there is change in the shape of the body also. The hips become larger and curvier. So the hips become larger, curvier. The legs also, the thighs also are bigger as compared to your male classmates. So the hips become rounder, the breasts become rounder, the hips become wider also, and there is weight gain on the hips. So these are few changes. So this is one thing which everybody, I want everybody to actually see it. This is our body. So this is our body. On the left side you can see that what is there in between your legs, and the right side you can see what is there in your lower belly. So in between your legs there is a private part and it has three holes. Okay, so this is the only thing I want to tell you. There are three holes. First is called the urethra. So I have made like three pink holes. First is the urethra where you pass your urine. The other is one hole which is called vagina, and here where you have the menstrual bleeding. This is the place where you have the bleeding. And the third one is for the stools. It is called the anus. So three holes, three separate holes. It is not the same place where you are peeing. So one is the urethra, the second one is the vagina, three is the anus. So every girl should know that there are three holes there. And in the lower belly you have a uterus and you have two ovaries and two fallopian tube. This is in your lower belly. Every girl has these things in the lower belly. Then there is the vagina, which the whole of the vagina you can see in between your legs. So what is a period? So I have a very small video for you to know how the period is generated and why it starts and why we have to go through the period every month. So let me play the video. Can you see it?
No, ma'am.
We can see the presentation, the first page.
Can you see this? No.
Yes, ma'am.
Just wait for a second. I think
we can see the first page.
Now,
ma'am, we are only
no, ma'am.
Able to see the video.
No,
ma'am.
So. Now you can, what slide you see? What is the period?
Puberty.
Puberty.
So you have
Ma'am,
not
you
seen.
Can try stop presenting and then present again.
Okay. So present now. So till now you have not seen anything. You have seen only puberty.
Yes, ma'am.
Now,
yes, ma'am.
Can you see? What you can see? You can see this.
Puberty.
You can see the. You can see the R body.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
You did not see it earlier. You did not see it earlier.
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Okay.
No,
ma'am. So now again, see what is there in between your legs and what is there in the lower belly. Now you can see the three holes. So the three holes is urethra, the vagina, and the anus. So the urethra is for urine, the vagina is for the menstrual blood, and the anus is to pass the stools. Okay, and then the lower belly we have a uterus, and we have the fallopian tube, and we have the ovary. Okay, so now you can see the next slide or not? What is the period?
No,
no,
ma'am.
No,
ma'am.
No, we can see our body.
Okay. I don't know how this is happening.
Ma'am,
but you can
scroll down to the next slide. You scroll down to the next slide, ma'am.
So I am ending the show. Can you see now?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Okay. So I am scrolling down the next slides, but I don't know how it is happening.
You have not shared the screen.
I have. See?
No, no, it is not.
Now you can see it?
Ma'am, please try again.
Yes.
This is the second, third time I'm trying to.
Screen is not shared, ma'am.
Now?
No, ma'am.
Ma'am, click on share option, full screen share.
That, so it's already showing me meetgoogle.com is sharing a window. Stop
now
sharing.
Yes, ma'am. Now we can see.
What is the period that slide is coming now?
Okay, you can see. So I'm not making it a slideshow. I'm just going to show it like this only. Okay. So can you see now this next slide?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so I'm going to play it. Now you can see?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes,
yes, ma'am. Ma'am, do this video have audio?
Yeah.
We cannot hear.
So okay, I'll tell you what they're saying, okay? So all you need to know about your periods is here in the video. So women have an amazing ability to create life, and it all begins with puberty. So puberty, you have many physical changes like growing taller, development of breast, and start of a regular cycle known as a period. So without a period, a woman would not be able to have children. So nobody knows why it starts at 12, but it starts. Some start at 9. Some might start at 14. Generally, it starts at the age of 12. So all these reproductive organs, the ovary and the uterus. So this is the tube and the uterus. So there are many eggs in the ovary. This is the hormones which we have in the body. The ovary produces these hormones. So this is the main hormone, which is called the estrogen. Estrogen results in increased length, increase in the breast. So this is the egg which is coming from the ovary and comes into the uterus. So it can, this egg can live only for 24 hours. If there is no sperm, there will be no pregnancy. Then the period begins 10 to 14 days after the eggs come into the uterus. So this is body's way to start to have the ability to reproduce every month. So as this video told you that the eggs are produced from the ovary, that every month one egg is produced which comes into the uterus, and if there is no pregnancy, then after 14 days the lining of the uterus, the inside lining of the uterus, the secretions of the uterus and some amount of blood comes out from the vagina. So it is not just the blood, it is also the secretion and the lining or the tissue also. So that's why the amount which we lose in the menstruation, it is not completely blood. So there is no need to feel that we are losing so much blood. It is a combination of many things. Can you see the slide now?
Yes.
So what do you use when you have a period? So every month it will happen. So what do you use for it? So there are different kinds of sanitary pads available. So you can buy whatever suits you, because the amount of bleeding is different for every girl. So we will come to the next slide where I'll tell you that how it varies. So there are different kinds of sanitary pads. There are different kinds of tampons also. So these are tampons. The tampons, you can see like a capsule formed there in the green part. We can put this once the teenage years are gone, after the age of I think 17 and 18. I advise girls that they can use tampon also. So tampon is to be inserted into the vagina, and then once after 4, 5, 6 hours you can remove the tampon. But till the age of 17 to 18 years, it is best to use a sanitary pad, or you can, which is a disposable sanitary pad, and there are other cloth pads also nowadays. Earlier it was said that don't use cloth at all, but you can use very good absorbent cloth also, which can be cleaned and dried in sun. So so earlier women used to use dirty cloth, which was, and then they used to not clean it with detergent. So that way it was considered unhygienic. But at this point of time, women do use cloth pads also, and they are also comfortable, and these usually don't give allergic reactions like many sanitary pads do. So sanitary pads are sometimes made up of plastic, and other gel material is also there. So it can cause allergic reactions to girls. So that's why you have to find out which one is the best pad for you. So keep in the very early years, your mother will actually buy. You can buy few brands and then check out which one is good for you. And then the other one which I've shown you is a menstrual cup. You can see a cup in the green the green part. So yes, that cup is called a menstrual cup, and that is also used after the age of 18. And this thing is also inserted. This is pinched and inserted into the vagina, which is one big opening in between our legs. So what is the average cycle length? So usually the cycle length varies between 21 to 35 days. So some girls might be having a 21 day cycle, some might be having 27 day, some 28, some 31. And some people might also be having the 21, one time it comes on 21 days, the other time it comes at 27 days, 24 days. So this can also happen, but average, usually it comes between 21 and 35. If it is not coming, if it is coming like every 15 days, then it is a problem. You have to go to the doctor. If it is coming after 35 days, like if a girl is having period in 2 to 3 months, it is not regular, it is not coming every month, it is coming in 40 days, every 50 day or every 60 day, then it is a problem and you have to see a doctor. If it is coming between 21 and 35 days, then it's okay. It is the average cycle length. So the cycle length varies. So in the first or second year, like if you've started your periods at 12, 13, 14, till like the first, after the initiation of period, the first 1 or 2 year, you might have a irregular cycle also. Means you might have a delayed cycle, but after 1 or 2 years, usually you will have a regular cycle. So if it is coming in 27 days, so usually it would be coming in 27 days. Like in the very beginning, when we're starting a menstrual cycle, when the menarche comes, then you might have a irregular cycle also. That's completely normal. And there is no need to go to the doctor in those 1 or 2 years. But if the periods are coming like too early, every 15 days, then it's a problem. Even at the age of 12, the girl should go to the doctor. So the duration of bleeding. The duration of bleeding is usually between 3 to 7 days. So some girls might be having it for 3 days. Some girls might be having for 7 days. So if you're having bleeding for more than 7 days, then it's better to show a doctor that why you're bleeding for so many days. But the duration also varies. It depends. It's a unique, it's unique for everybody. Some might be, if you don't think that your friend is having for 5 days and you're having for 6 days, then it's a problem. It also varies. Now the amount of bleeding. The amount of bleeding also varies between individual to individual, and it also varies between first day to last day. So the first day, there might be like little bleeding, and then after second day, it might be heavy bleeding. And the usually most of the time, the heaviest days are second day and third days. So it varies between, the amount of bleeding varies between day to day, and the initial days and the last days, usually it is very less. And it can be in the form of spotting also, that even if you put a pad, there is a spot of blood or there is brownish discharge there. Brownish discharge means the old blood. So on the usually in the end of the cycle, it is brownish discharge, and it is normal to have that kind of a brown discharge at the end of the period. So now you have known that there are these periods, and these come every month, or can it, because it varies, it can happen anytime. It can happen any time of the day, morning, evening, anytime, and can have happen unexpected also. So always keep pads in your bag. Okay, in your bag, purse, whatever, at any age, every lady actually has to think about the unpredictability of the cycle. So there should be something in your bag, especially if you're going to school. And if at all you are using a pad and you think that it's getting wet, then anytime you can ask your teachers about, and they'll arrange it for you. So type and size of the pad, as I told you, is your choice. But it is better to change every 6 hours in the daytime, and in the night time you have to use only one pad. So they are usually bigger pads which girls use in the night. But in the daytime, it's good that you actually change it in 6 hours. Like if you're in a big meeting, if you're in the school and it's you have to wear it for 8 hours and use a bigger pad. But it is better that you change it every 6 hours, even if you are having little bleeding. Why I'm saying so? Because after some time, the pads sometimes start to stink also, and there might be microbes growing in the blood. So just to maintain hygiene, we ask everybody to change it in 6 hours. So one big thing which I want to tell you is that the disposable pads are not to be disposed in the pot. Okay, they are disposable, but don't dispose in the pot, because the pot will clog with it. So this is important thing which we need to tell every girl, that don't dispose in the pot anywhere, either in home, either in school. There you should properly actually wrap it and then dispose the pad. So if you're using a cloth pad, then clean it after use with detergent and dry it in sunlight. So once you are able to do it, then only use a cloth pad, otherwise use a disposable pad. Now mark your calendar is the best. Is I think every girl should do it, any age you should do it. So I'll tell you how to do it. So like this is January 2017, like your period started on 1st, so you, this is mark it or color it. This is colored. So you bled for 5 days. Okay, you bled for 5 days, you have marked it. Again your period came on 30th. Okay, so your period came on 30th, so you marked it on 30, 31, then February 1st, 2nd, 3rd. So this time also you bled for 5 days. Now, how to calculate that, what is your period length? How do you calculate? What you do is that this, what is the difference between 1st and 30? So it is 29 days. So this time your period came in 29 days. Now, if you calculate here that your period came first 30, and the next time it came on 28. So from 30th to 28. How many days were passed? 29 days. So this girl has a cycle length of 29 days. So that's how, and every time you can actually predict it if you can, you are marking your calendar. And it is a, I think, very good practice from the very beginning to always, if anybody asks you when was your last period, you should be able to tell them, find it out, tell them, or remember it. I think nobody can remember it because it's a different date every time. So it's better to mark in your calendar. Nowadays, there are apps in the phone where you can mark every time and they will predict your periods. And one day before the period, they will remind you that your predicted date is tomorrow. Okay. So, but it's a good thing to mark, always mark it and know when was your last period. So what are the activities you can do in period? So most of the things you do on routine days, you can do in your menstrual days. So most of it, you have to go to school. If there is a games period, you go to the games period. So most of the activities you can do, I would say that avoid swimming, don't swim. But most of the things you can do, avoid very strenuous exercises during your period, especially when you are having heavier days like second, third, fourth day. Avoid very strenuous, high intensity workouts. Avoid strenuous abdominal exercises. So where like setups, these kind of exercises, the abdominal exercises, avoid those exercises in your periods, and avoid being upside down for long periods. So if you are hanging upside down or you're doing yoga, headstand or something, so avoid those kind of exercises in your periods. You can do all other kinds of yoga, just avoid postures where you're doing upside down or doing abdominal exercises. So what is heavy period? So I've told you about the average, but what is a heavy period? When you should go to the doctor? So bleeding for more than 7 days, if you're bleeding for more than 7 days, if your periods come less than 20 days, every 20 days or less, if your periods come later than 35 days, if you're using more than 7 to 8 large pads per day, or if you are passing clots or big small chunks of blood, then you're having a heavy period. So any girl who sometimes, if you, once you know that this is heavy period, then only you can tell your mother and that I'm having heavy periods. So everybody should know that this is called heavy period, and you should go to the doctor to find out why you are having heavy periods. Now, menstrual cramps, this is also a very common thing. This is very common, and some amount of pain is normal. So every woman has a some kind of discomfort in the lower belly when they have their periods. And why it happens is because the uterus has to expel the blood and the secretion and everything out. Okay, because the uterus has to expel, so the muscle of the uterus actually churns, you can say churns, so that the blood and everything comes out, is pushed out. So because of that, there is some amount of pain. So what is what is called too much pain, when you should go to the doctor? Then these home remedies, which I'm going to tell you, if they don't work, or if there is so much pain that you're not able to go to the school, if you're not able to do your routine activities, if you're not able to study the whole day, if you're not able to study on the second day, that is called severe pain. Otherwise, some amount of pain, mild to moderate pain, happens, and there is no need to take any medication for it. So how to relieve this pain? You can do few yoga postures, and I think if you can do light yoga, you can do massage of oil in the lower belly, you can use hot compresses, or there are many home remedies of the herbs by the mother, where they put fennel seeds or adrak or ginger into water and give to you. So that is also effective. And pills by the doctor if the pain hinders in the routine activities. And during the periods, avoid carbonated drinks, salty food and sugary food, because that also creates a lot of bloating at the time of periods and can also aggravate the cramps. So try to eat a healthy diet during your periods and just before the period. Some girls have pain in the breast before the period, pain and swelling in the breast before the period. That also some amount of is normal. So it is normal, but to avoid it, just don't take just take less sugary food and less carbohydrate in the premenstrual time. So what are the myths about the period? There are many myths in the community about the period, that once a girl or a woman or whoever it is, if a girl or woman or even a old lady, so usually these the periods happen between the age of 12 to 50 years. Okay, after the age of 50, the period stops. So in between these years, anybody who has it, they put some restrictions that don't touch the pickles in the period, don't touch the sacred things, don't enter into the temple, don't go to the kitchen and touch the food, don't work out. So these are all myths. There is no factual information in this, that touching the pickle will not spoil the pickle, and it is nothing dirty, and it is a normal phenomena. Like it is a normal phenomena. So a point about the vaginal discharge. So you can see here in the slide I have made that the mouth, the nose, the eyes, the ears. So all these are mucous membranes. These are the opening of our body. The mouth is the opening, nostrils, nose is the opening, eye is the opening, ear is the opening. So all these openings have some or the other kind of secretion. They produce some, like there is saliva in the mouth. There is nasal secretion in the nose. There are some secretion or tears in the eyes always. So it is wet always. And in the ear also there is earwax. So there is some or the other secretion from the openings. So it is normal to have secretion from the vagina also. It is also opening. So small amount of vaginal secretion can be seen in your panty. If you are wearing the panty for 12 hours or you're using it for 24 hours, you might see a small patch of discharge or secretion on the panty. It is normal. So this is, it is not abnormal, it is normal. Secretion, there is always some secretion from the opening, and it is normal from vagina also. So what is normal and abnormal vaginal discharge? Sometimes the discharge can be abnormal also. So no, what is normal? Normal is whitish or translucent. It is something like our nasal discharge. So it is slightly whitish, can be slightly whitish, or it can be translucent also, means between transparent. What is translucent? Which is between whitish and transparent. So, and what is abnormal? Abnormal is too much discharge, means there is wetting of your panty. So abnormal is too much discharge, thick white discharge, and associated with itching or burning of your private parts. So this is abnormal discharge, and anybody who has it should go to the doctor. But otherwise, normally also there is discharge. So don't get panic and don't go to the doctor if you have small amount of discharge from the vagina. So another thing is how to maintain the hygiene of the area, of the private parts. To clean with lots of water every day. Clean it with lots of water every day. Dry it after urination with toilet paper. So how you should dry it? Always dry it from front to back. Don't use the toilet paper from back to front. Why we tell this? Because there is stools or potty in the anus, in the last opening. So if you bring it from back to up, then you will bring some dirt also to your vagina. So it is always clean it from front to back, and then dry it every time you go for to pass urine. Every time you go for to the washroom, dry it with a toilet paper. Try to use a cotton panty and sleep in loose clothes. So if you do this and clean it and keep it dry, if you clean your private parts with water and keep it dry, there is a very small possibility of having any kind of infectious disease there. The infections happen if we are not cleaning it while we are taking a bath. Second thing, we are not drying it when we go to the bathroom, because it gets wet when we go to the bathroom, because the opening of urine is, you know, the above the vagina. So when the urine trickles, it will make everything wet, even though they are separate holes, but it will make the vagina also wet. So dry it, use a cotton panty, because there is good ventilation in a cotton panty. And so use a cotton panty. And why sleep in loose clothes? Because even if you are using tight clothes in the morning or daytime, or if you are wearing jeans or anything, but in the evening always sleep in loose clothes so that there is good ventilation. Your private parts are dry in the evening hours. So I think this is my presentation, and I will ask everybody to put questions.
Thank you so much, ma'am. It's been quite informative session. Now, if anyone has a question, please raise your hand and ask the question. You can switch on your mic before you speak.
Yes, Naisa Mutra.
Yes, ma'am. Good afternoon, ma'am. This is Nayasha Mundra and I'm from grade 11. Ma'am, my question to you is, what should we do if in case there is an emergency and we have no sanitary napkins and also no stores open to buy them?
There's no store. So, whatever you have, then you have to use it. But if you have a hanky, then you have to use a hanky. And whatever clean thing you have, it you have to use. You can use the toilet papers also. If you have to use it, then you have to use this. I think anybody, see, never, never, ever feel shy to ask help from any girl, any woman near close to you. So anybody, I'm sure you will not be in a place where you will not find anybody close to you. So other girls might be having it. They might be having something else. So always, never, to everybody, even to me, if it happens unexpectedly at any point of time, then if I don't have it, I'll try to find somebody who's a woman or a girl and ask her that this has happened and I'm down and it has unpredicted. It came and I don't have a sanitary pad. Can you help me? So this can be done, and this is the advice. This is the first advice. And if you don't find anything, I think you have to use whatever you have. You have to use or whatever clothes. I think if you have an old T-shirt, then you will use the old T-shirt. Okay. So you will not be staining other clothes. So this is what you have to do. But I'm sure you will find somebody who can help you.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah. So Muskan Sinha has asked that what is the reason for period cramp? As I told you, that the uterus has muscle and there is a collection of blood inside. So the uterus has to push. So when the uterus is pushing, so that's why the pain happens, and there are some hormones released which cause this pain. So this is normal. So Rajul Rai, yes. Rajul Rai, unmute yourself.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning. Yes.
Good morning. Good afternoon, ma'am. I'm Rajul Rai, and I have a question that every time before my menstruation starts, I used to have high discharge a lot.
So, as I told you,
what is it? Different problem.
So, as I told you, that high discharge is normal if you are not having itching, and if it is not foul smelling, it's okay. Okay, and if it is not copious means that you are wetting your panty, so little bit of discharge is okay. If you're not having itching, and if it is not foul smelling, then it's okay. Little bit of discharge is normal. Any other question?
Dr. Sarika, Himangi Goel is asking if tell about PCOS or PCOD.
Yeah, so PCOS is a lifestyle disease, and nowadays it is very common, and 50% of the girls might be having PCOS in the class. And why it happens is because of the sedentary habit, because we are not working out as much as we need to. Other thing is we are eating a carbohydrate rich diet. Carbohydrate rich diet and sugary diet. We are not sleeping at the right time. We are not getting up at the right time, and there is no routine. This is why PCOS happens. It is a lifestyle disease. No medicines can help till the time you change the lifestyle. So change the lifestyle, and then you will not need the medication. So PCOS is called polycystic ovary disease, and by it the ovaries don't function because they are in a shock that what kind of life we are in. You understand? So if you are not active, if you're not working out as hard as you're eating, so then it happens. So try and sleep at the right time, get up at the right time. Don't have like a bad circadian rhythm. Don't sleep at 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock and get up late, and sleep at least 6 to 7 hours. And this is, I think, this is the advice whoever has is having irregular periods, means delayed periods, periods in 2 to 3 months. This PCOS causes increased facial hairs and hairs in other parts of the body. Then it can lead to weight gain also. And maybe later on infertility, means not able to produce children. Yes. Ma'am, does povidone iodine help to prevent vitiligo? No. So povidone iodine, no, don't use povidone iodine till the doctor tells you this is not, you don't use. I also don't advise the washes. I think plain water is the best, and don't use povidone iodine, don't use anything. Just use plain water. And there are some amount of discharge is normal, as I told you. It's normal. It happens to everybody. Ask anybody. If you're not having discharge, then it's a problem. So, ma'am, do we have mood swings during period? Yes, you can have mood swings during period. You're right. And it is also normal. So, if you can ask, ma'am, Nazia, ma'am, if you can ask questions which they have put up.
Yes,
and
yes.
Because
Kirti Gupta has raised her hand. Can you unmute and ask the question? What was the question? Kirti?
Ma'am, why does loose motion happen in period time?
Yeah, loose motions also happen in period time sometimes to very few girls. So it happens because the uterus produces, now I was telling you, some prostaglandins. And these prostaglandin is the reason to cause cramps and pain. And this only causes, this also causes loose stools during period. So how many loose stools are you talking about? Is it too much? I think it would be little, the consistency might be loose and you might be going 2-3 times in a day maybe. Yeah, it happens too, but there is no need to go to the doctor. It will slowly, it will be better.
Okay. Shaifin has asked whether, as most of the schools, like as this is a boarding school.
Yes.
He's asking if the school girls comes to the school for joining the school, what they should pack from home or to help them during the severe premenstrual symptoms, with the severe premenstrual symptoms. Or there could be a provision in school to be provided for such conditions.
No, I could not understand. No. If a girl comes to the boarding
school. This is a boarding school. Most of the girls are coming in here.
Yes.
Like from home after school after holidays.
Yes.
What should be like packed from home? Like
okay.
What should be prepared?
Some
kind of identity she is asking about.
Like, yeah,
they should pack it from home, or there should be a provision in the school.
I think there should be, if it's a girl's school, there should be provision. If it's a boarding school, there should be a provision of pads, because nobody can actually judge how many pads they might be needing in what kind of period. Some days you might need 3 pads, some days you need 4. So, and how much you can pack. So you can bring what you want, but I think there should be some facility at the place if you are residing. At some place, then I think it's a good thing to have pads available there, so that you can buy them or you can.
And I just would add on this, Shelly, that in our infirmary, in our school, we do have keep the pads in addition, as well as we keep the medication we are required in case of the severe menstrual pain. So we do have a provision that with us. So if anyone does not have pad or any emergency cases where severe pain is there, we can manage at our school.
So I can see now, I can see the question. So period cramps, PCOD, providine iodine told you,
yes.
Mood swings,
ma'am,
also told you it happens.
Ma'am, Arya Singh has asked, menstrual cup actually helps, does it helps actually during the period?
What?
Menstrual cup.
Menstrual cup, I see it's a good thing to use, because you can, but for somebody, I would like the girls after the age of 18 to use that, and before that I would ask them either to use pads only, because before that it is, one should know their body very well before using such kind of things. And because they are young, they are starting to know their body, and maybe once they are familiar with the periods, then they can use this cup also, because there is some discomfort when you put it in, and in the very beginning. So these young girls, I think it would be difficult to bear that discomfort in the very beginning. They can do it once they are, after few years, they are like matured, and then they know that this, then they know better. So after the age of 18, they can use menstrual cup, and menstrual cup is a good thing. And I encourage women using menstrual cup after the age of 18. It's a good thing to use. There is no problem in that.
Anusha Agarwal has a question that if the bleeding continues more than 20 to 30 days and stops only after medication, is this harmful?
No, it is harmful. It is very harmful. So it is continuing for 20 to 30 days. You should go to the doctor, and they will give you medicine. Those that don't have it for 20 to 30 days. Nobody should have continuous bleeding for 20 to 30 days. More than 7 days, go to the doctor, find out why you're bleeding so much. The other question is, what is the role of prolactin hormone? So prolactin hormone has no role in the menstrual. What happens is that when prolactin hormone is secreted more than what it should be, then the periods can stop. But in a regular cycle, it has no role. Most of the role is by FSH-LH and estrogen progesterone. But because prolactin hormone can suppress the brain, so that's why the hypothalamus and the pituitary gland. So that's why you can stop your periods if somebody has high levels of prolactin hormone.
Kirti Gupta has a question, like how can we cure the PCOD and how much time it takes to be cured?
Yeah, I told you that try, just change your lifestyle. Don't think that your friend is also is having the same lifestyle, but her periods are regular. Because if your body is responding in such a way to the lifestyle you have, then you have to change your lifestyle. You have to live a very simple lifestyle. Eat healthy, eat greens, reduce carbohydrate, reduce sugary food, and reduce your weight by exercising more. So this is a way to cure PCOD. Otherwise, there is no way to cure. You will take the medication, but it will help till the time you're taking the medication. The next question is, what is the best way to remove pubic hair? So the best way to remove pubic hair is, you can actually wax, and you can also use creams to remove pubic hair. Okay, and it is not a necessity. See, and the other thing is, you can cut the longer hairs. This is the best way. Why? Because just to maintain your hygiene, it is enough to cut them short. Just take a scissor, hold it, and cut them short. You will not see a clean, you will not see as clean as you see in with using a shaving or creams, but it is harmless, and hygiene wise also it gives you good hygiene, because then there is it stays dry because the hairs are shorter. And I think the best thing is to just cut them with a scissor if they are too long.
Khushi Agrawal has a question, ma'am. Say, asking, is it like some girls do use medicine to increase areas? I think she means that postponing for the period.
No, it is not advised. Don't do it. Why do you do it? But why would you like to delay your periods? Just tell me, when you have to do everything. I told you that all routine activities can be done during a period. Why do you want to delay it? It is not advisable at all. Never do it. Never to take this medication. Never use those medication. Why would you want to delay it? I don't understand this. So if you are well aware why the period happens, and this is a normal thing, if your mindset is this, that this is normal and this is like a normal day for me, and this will happen throughout my life. So if your mindset changes, then I think you will never try to change the period date. So what is the maximum age of getting period? So as I told you that 14 years your period should come. and if even if after 14 years or 15 years it's not coming, you should immediately go to the doctor. There might be many tests might be done to find out your hormonal profile. Menstrual cups are hygienic. They can be hygienic if you are washing them and drying them, then it's hygienic, and they can be kept there for 6 hours only. And how can we choose the best brand? So there are so many brands, and I think I know one or two brands, Serona, I know, and P Body brand is there. There are so many brands coming now, and you can use any one of them. And actually, maybe because the sizes, because you are young, all of you are young, so get the smallest size. If you're getting it, get the smallest size, because the bigger ones are for women who have given birth to children. So pick the smallest size, and the brand also, the shapes are different. So you might be, maybe you buy one, and then if you don't like it, you think that it is too hard for you or too soft for you, then you might like to change it also. It is also like sanitary pads. It is not this one thing for everybody. You have to pick and choose whichever it suits you best. Tampons are harmful or not? Tampons are not harmful. If you're removing them every 6 hours, then they are not harmful.
Ma'am, Deva Darshanaha Kalita has a question. Can we use the painkillers if we cannot bear the cramps?
If you cannot bear the cramps, then you can use painkillers. But before that, if you go to the doctor, they can find out if there is some disease you are having, and that's why you are having these means severe pain. If they do ultrasound and they find out that there is nothing to worry about, then you take your medication and then don't worry. So before, if whoever is having severe pain, na, go to the doctor and then start taking your medication.
Okay, I think we have addressed. Is there anyone who are having more questions?
If my period is delayed for more than 35 days and now because of lockdown I'm not able to contact the doctor, then so what should I do? So if your period was delayed for more than 35 days, then if it is the first time it has happened, then wait for 10 more days. If this has happened for the first time, wait for 10 more days. And if it doesn't happen in the next 10 days, what I would say is that you can take online consultation also. Take online consultation from the doctor in the lockdown. Material used in particular is good. I mean, case of menstrual cup. So in the menstrual cup, see, you have to find out. There are so many companies. I don't know. Just you have to find out the silicone. It should be silicone, and then you can see the reviews. There are so many companies and people. I have used Serona, but there are different sizes, and my friends use different name brand names. So it's up to you. Find it out for yourself. It should be silicone though, and just clean it whenever if you use it, clean it. But before using a cup, I would ask you, try a tampon first. Why? Because tampon is smaller, and if you are able to introduce a tampon, then only try a cup.
Himali has a question asking,
laser removal, no, it's not harmful, but you do it after the age of 18. It's not harmful, do it after the age of 18.
Okay. So I think we are done. Yeah, let me invite Naina ma'am for thank you. Thank you, sir, Dr. Sarika, for
thank you.
Okay, good afternoon, Dr. Sarika.
Good afternoon. Yes, ma'am.
Good afternoon, Dr. Sarika. I'm the principal, Mrs. Naina Dhillon. Just wanted to thank you for a really enlightening talk. I think the girls have lots of questions and it will probably not stop it. We don't stop it. But we hope to meet you again. We would love to have you on board with us again. Thank you so much. I think girls at this stage need all the correct information that they can get, because normally children are just exchanging news, a lot of rumors. Sometimes there are families where things like this are not discussed openly, which they should be, but I'm glad that we were able to give them this platform, and thank you so much for spending this time. I'd also like to thank Dr. Naz and Ms. Pragya for organizing this talk. And we hope that when the situation does improve, you're able to visit our school and come and spend time with us and have a real interaction. Thank you. Have a great day.
Thank you. Thank you, ma'am. It was a pleasure. Thank you.